Question number 25. The metal powder used in thermite welding of steel is options tungsten and copper, lead, aluminium. In thermite welding, aluminium is used. Option D is correct. Thermite welding heat is produced by chemical reactions between metal oxides, that is iron oxide Fe3O4, and a metal reducing agent alumina. Okay. The metal powders used are alumina and Fe3 iron oxide. The chemical affinity of aluminium for oxygen is a basis for the thermite welding. So, welding process in which heat is produced for welding by chemical reactions is known as thermite welding. Okay. In chemical reactions are used chemical reactions between Fe3O3, Fe3O4 and alumina is the basis for thermite welding. In thermite welding, chemical reaction involves alumina and iron oxide in 1:3 proportion. Alumina 1 proportion and iron oxide in 3 times proportion powders are used in thermite welding process. Thermite welding is used in the 1:3 ratio. This is placed in a furnace and it is ignited. So chemical reaction takes place. Due to this, a liquid and slag are formed which are used for welding. For welding heavy parts such as rails, broken machine frames, rebuilding of large gears, the welding process used is thermite welding. Okay. For welding, for repairing rails and broken machine frames, cast iron frames and rebuilding large gears, okay, and the process used is thermite welding. Option C is correct. So this is arrangement of thermite welding process, and alumina is ignited in the crucible and it is poured into the part where the gap has to be filled in, then match the correct pass. So friction welding, gas metal arc welding, tungsten inert gas welding and electro slag welding. Okay, friction welding, joining of cylindrical dissimilar metals. So option A is correct. P4, friction welding, joining of cylindrical dissimilar metals. Gas metal arc welding, it uses consumable electrode wire, and tungsten inert gas welding uses non consumable electrode wires, and electro slag welding, it is used for joining thick plates up to 900 mm. Okay, we are going to study it in the later. So electro slag welding, it is used to join very thick plates up to 900 mm thickness, but gas metal arc welding can weld up to 6 mm thickness. Electro slag welding can join work pieces up to 9 cm thickness or 900 mm thickness. So option A is correct. Preheating before welding is done to, so options, make steel softer, burn away oil, grease, etc. from the plate surface, prevent cold cracks, prevent plate distortion. So option C is correct. Preheating is done to prevent cold cracks. TIG welding is best suited for welding. Options, mild steel, carbon steel, aluminium, stainless steel. It is best suited for welding aluminium. Grey cast iron is welded by submerged arc welding, gas welding, manual arc welding, TIG welding. It is used by gas welding, ordinary simple oxyacetylene gas welding. Option B is correct. Within the heat affected zone in a fusion welding process, the work material undergoes, options, microstructural changes, does not melt, neither melting nor microstructural changes, both melting and microstructural changes, melts but microstructure does not change. Here, the microstructure within the heat affected zone within the parent material during the fusion welding process, microstructural changes will occur but it does not melt. So option A is correct. The welding technique in which the flux is in the form of granules is, options, tungsten inert gas welding, submerged arc welding, shielded metal arc welding, laser beam welding. The option is submerged arc welding. Option B is correct. So flux is used in the form of granules. Okay, in the submerged arc welding, in which the welding is done by producing an electric arc between the consumable bar electrode and the workpiece, such that electrode is submerged or hidden under the flux powder. Okay, so the electrode is electrode is submerged under the flux powder. Electrode is in the granulated welding flux. It is in the form of granules. Flux otherwise is an insulator, but once it melts due to the heat of the arcs, it becomes highly conductive. Okay, so it is an insulator, but due to the heat of the arc, it becomes highly conductive. Upper portion of the flux in contact with the atmosphere, which is visible, remains granular and can be reused. Okay, the granules, that is granules, can be reused. The flux is, some part of the flux is used for some part of the flux becomes slag, and remaining granular flux can be reused. Okay, this is the arrangement of submerged arc welding. Okay, this is the electrode, and this is the granules, and the remaining granules can be used, and other and the lower part of the granular flux become slag. Advantages of submerged arc welding: high deposition rates can be possible, and higher welding speeds and deep penetration. These two are the advantages of submerged arc welding, that is higher welding speed and deep penetration. Okay, these are all the advantages of submerged arc welding. It can be used for joining many structural shapes, earth moving equipment, pipes, railroad construction, locomotives and ship building, repairing machine parts. Okay, main advantage of MIG welding, metal inert gas welding, over tungsten inert gas welding is options. Former can be used to weld hard metals. Former permits use of large currents. Okay, former is MIG and later is TIG. Welding rate is very fast. Welding is completely automatic. There is MIG welding permits the use of large currents. Okay, former, this is correct. Okay, so the MIG welding cannot be used to weld hard metals. Okay, this is wrong. Welding rate is very fast. It is also wrong. Welding is completely automatic. It is also wrong. So the former MIG welding permits use of large currents. So option B is correct. The electrodes used in arc welding is coated. This coating is not expected to, okay, the coating is expected to provide protective atmosphere to weld. So it prevent oxidation and it stabilize the arc. It is also correct. Okay, and it add alloying elements to the parent metal. It is also correct. It prevent the electrode from contamination. It is wrong. Okay, first three are correct, and the for D is wrong. So option D is selected. In atomic hydrogen welding, hydrogen acts as options a heating agent, one of the gases to generate flame, and effective shielding gas protecting the weld, a lubricant to increase the flow characteristics of weld metal. So in atomic hydrogen welding, hydrogen acts as an effective shielding gas protecting the weld. In which of the following are the major characteristics of submerged arc welding? As I already told, it allows higher penetration. Okay, high welding speeds and high deposition rates are the properties of submerged arc welding. So 1 and 2 are correct. Okay, speeds as high as 5 meter per minute and higher penetration rate, since flux acts as thermal insulator. Okay, higher deposition rates can also be possible, not higher penetration. So it provides high welding speeds and high deposition rates. So option D is correct. The material used for coating electrode is called flux. Okay, the material used for coating electrode is called, it is not deoxidizer or binder or flux or slag. So slag is formed after the welding, and it is also called chip, and this the chip can be removed by chipping hammer. Okay, the flux become slag after the welding process. So option C is correct. The most suitable welding process for joining very thick plates is electro slag welding, gas metal arc welding, gas tungsten arc welding, oxy acetylene welding. Electro slag welding, so it can be used to weld more than 900 mm thickness plates. 9 cm thickness plates can be welded using the electro slag welding. In gas metal arc welding, can be used to weld up to only 6 mm thick plates. And this gas tungsten arc welding can be used to weld titanium, aluminium, magnesium and titanium. this tungsten arc welding can be used. Oxyacetylene welding can also be used to weld up to 6 mm. So electroslag welding can be used to weld jobs up to 900 mm thickness. Okay, so some 300 to 900 mm thickness plates can be welded using electroslag welding. So option A is correct. Electroslag welding, flux is added and then it is melted by the heat of the arc. After the molten slag reaches the tip of the electrode, the arc is extinguished. Okay, this is a very basic principle of electroslag welding. Flux is added and it is melted by the heat of the arc. Okay, initially it will act as a arc welding. Okay, flux is added and it is melted by the heat of the arc. After the molten slag reaches the tip of the electrode, the arc is extinguished. Okay, the arc is extinguished. The heat is then produced continuously by the electrical resistance of the molten slag. Okay, so using this only very high thickness plates can be welded. Okay, so flux is added and is melted by the heat of the arc. So first using arc welding procedure, and the molten slag is produced, and the molten slag, after the molten slag is reaches the tip of the electrode, arc is extinguished. Okay, no longer the arc welding no longer exists. Then heat is produced by the electrical resistance of the molten slag, and electrical resistance is given and it produces the molten slag. This is a working of molten slag welding process. Okay, the power, that is, this is a molten slag. Okay, this is a weld pool, this is a molten slag, and the arc is extinguished, and the molten slag electrical resistance is given, and due to the electrical resistance the welding process is carried out. In resistance welding, okay, next topic, resistance welding, heat is generated due to resistance between electrode and workpiece, inner atomic forces, two dissimilar metals in contact, asperities between touching plates. Okay, in electrical resistance welding, heat is generated due to the not due to the resistance between electrode and workpiece, not due to inner atomic forces, not due to the two dissimilar metals in contact, it is due to the asperities between touching plates. So option D is correct. So resistance welding can be of different types: butt welding, spot welding, seam welding, projection welding, percussion welding. Okay, so we'll see about spot welding, seam welding, projection welding and percussion welding. First, spot welding. In resistance welding, parts to be joined are heated to the plastic state by the resistance to the flow of electric current, and mechanical pressure is applied to complete the weld. Initially, current is applied and resistance is produced and it is heated. After it is heated and it goes to the plastic state, mechanical pressure is applied to complete the weld. So here two copper electrodes are used. In resistance welding, copper electrodes are used, and the metal parts to be welded are placed between the electrodes. When the current is passed through the electrodes, the electrical resistance at the metal joints becomes very high. Okay, the metals are brought to red hot plastic condition, then mechanical pressure is applied to complete the weld. So this is the working of resistance welding. Here there are the two jobs, two plates are placed between the electrical circuits, and the higher electrical resistance is produced, and it is the place where to be welded is heated to very high temperature, and it goes to the plastic state, then mechanical pressure is applied to complete the weld. So this is the working of resistance welding. In resistance welding, the voltage required is approximately, so current required is more than 1 lakh, sometimes 10,000 amps to 1 lakh amps, but the voltage required is less than 10 volt. So voltage required is very less, but the current required is more. So the voltage required is approximately 10 volt. So option A is correct. Then applications are resistance welding. It can be used in automotive, auto supplies, electrical, electronics, aerospace, train carriage welding, radiator, domestic hardware, medical instruments, nuclear equipment, food and drink instruments, other metal processing industries. The material which is difficult to be spot welded is copper. For resistance spot welding of 1.5 mm thick steel plates, current required is in the order of 10,000 amps. Current is from 10,000 to 1 lakh amps. So option D is correct. Types of resistance welding: spot welding, seam welding, बट वेल्डिंग, प्रोजेक्शन वेल्डिंग, स्टड वेल्डिंग।